Let us proceed to the next example. Please take your own time to read and understand this question. You can pause this video for a while in order to do so. Okay, so after you have read this question, you should be able to come out with this sequence of 30, 32, 34, and so on. And the keyword for this question is actually the word total, where we need to use the SN formula, okay, not TN for this case. And these 50 rows here actually tell us that this is our N value, all right? And so what we have here is A is equals to 30, and D is equals to 32 minus 30 should give you 2, and our N in this case is the total number of rows, which is 50. Alright, so we need to calculate the total number of seats in this particular lecture hall. So substitute everything here. We've got A already, we've got D, and we've got N. So we actually need to calculate for the S50 equals to 50 over 2, and times with 2 times 30, so plus with 49 times 2. And suppose when we calculate this, we should get the total number of seats in this lecture hall equals to 3,950. Okay, so we've got this example now. So how many terms of the arithmetic sequence 579 must be added to get 572? All right, so the word how many terms refers to how many n actually. So we need to get the root of n. So what is the n value? And the word added here, all right, so the word added is actually refers to sum, and the word sum, which means we need to associate with the SN formula, all right, not TN formula. So basically this 572 is the SN. So what we have been given already in the question is, of course, A is equals to 5, D is equals to 7 minus 5 equals to 2, and our SN equals to 572. And for this case, we need to calculate the value of N. Okay, so in doing so, we will substitute everything into the SN formula and try to get the N value. Alright, so what we have here is SN equals to N over 2, 2A plus N minus 1D. And our SN is equals to 572. N is the one that we are looking for. So we have 2 times 5 here plus N minus 1. D is equals to 2. And suppose when we try to simplify inside the bracket first, so we should have 10 plus with 2N minus 2. And this 572 is still there. So we will simplify again the inside the bracket. So what we have here, 572 equals to N over 2. We have 8 plus 2N. All right, and I'm going to make this a little bit smaller so that we can have more space now. So so what we can continue is somehow we should expand this N over 2 to the inside the bracket, and eventually we should obtain 572 equals to 4N plus N squared. Alright, so we will simplify the denominator and rearrange this quadratic equation. We should get N squared plus 4N minus 572 equals to 0, and we need to make sure that it is in the simplest form before we factorize, and it is already. So factorizing this, we should get n minus 22 and n plus 26 equals to 0. So we have two values of n, which are n equals to 22 or n equals to negative 26, and we should reject this negative 26 since n needs to be greater than 0, or n needs to be positive because n is the number of terms, right? So therefore, n is equals to 22. All right, so please have a try in doing this exercise 6.1b. And suppose if you have any question, please don't hesitate to contact your lecturers. We are more than happy to help you there. All right, so that's all for the time being. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. Bye.